Friends, today let us study the heat transfer. That's a chapter, a unit in thermal engineering 1 of fourth semester, heat transfer. Introduction to heat transfer, that is how heat gets, heat you know is a form of energy, how heat gets transferred. Now let us say we have a metallic plate here. This side we are heating. Let us say we are heating this side. This is a metallic plate. We are heating here. So what happens is, after some time, this heat will travel through it and reach this place. From the bottom it will move to the top. Now here heat is getting transferred through this metallic plate and coming here. You know, you have seen this very commonly in a hotel. If you go to a hotel where they will be making dosas, now that plate is like this. There is a stove here. He has put a stove and he keeps heating here, and the heat is reaching here. So this is how heat is getting transferred from one place to another place. Now there are three modes of heat transfer. They are, one is conduction. Heat is transferred by conduction. It is transferred by convection. It is also transferred by radiation. These are the three modes. Now generally the conduction takes place through solid mediums. Now I gave you the example here. This plate, the metallic plate, is a solid medium. Here what happens is conduction is taking place. The particles of the medium are not moving. They are transferring heat from one particle to other particle, like that it keeps moving from bottom to the top. Now convection means, here this will be in liquid and gaseous mediums. This takes place in liquid and gaseous mediums. See here what happens. If you heat a water in a vessel, if you take a liquid in a vessel and heat it, now the particles here will get first heated. These particles will get heated, and what they do is they become lighter and they move upward, and these particles will move downwards. So like that heat is transferred from one particle to another particle due to movement of the heated particle. The transfer of heat takes place. That is called as convection. Radiation requires no medium. It can take place without a medium. For example, the heat from the sun reaches the earth without a medium, through radiation. So these are the three modes of heat transfer. Now we have to know these things, and you get a small problem also, you can get a numerical on conduction. Now then Newton's law of cooling says, suppose there is a plate here, or some obstruction is there. One side the temperature is T1 and the other side the temperature is T2. T1 is greater than T2. Now the heat will flow from this side to that side. The flow of heat will be from the higher temperature to the lower temperature. Through this medium it is traveling. Now Newton's law of cooling states the quantity of heat, amount of heat that is getting transferred is directly proportional to A, that is area of the surface. This plate will be like this. If this plate is like this, this area, what is the area of this plate? It depends upon that. Then it is directly proportional. That means greater is the area, greater is the heat transferred. Q is directly proportional to the difference in temperatures. Q is inversely proportional to the thickness of the medium. More is the thickness, less is the heat that is getting transferred. Less is the thickness, more is the heat transferred. So it is inversely proportional to the thickness of the medium. Now if you combine all these, Q is proportional to A into T1 minus T2 divided by X, or Q is equal to K, that is constant of proportionality. Whenever we change this sign to proportionality sign to equality sign, we have to introduce a constant divided by X. Here this K is constant of proportionality. Constant of proportionality, proportionality, it is called thermal conductivity, conductivity coefficient of the material of this plate. Coefficient, its unit is joule per meter degree Kelvin or watt per meter degree Kelvin. It is given like this. Now, this equation gives you the heat that is transferred in joules in 1 second, per second. Q, amount of heat that gets transferred from or through a wall. Suppose we have a furnace here. We have a furnace here. This is furnace where we are burning a fuel. Now this is atmosphere. Now this is at a higher temperature, so the heat moves outside here. Now if you want to limit it, what you have to do is you have to insulate it. Insulate it. Now for insulation, we have to use material which have low thermal conductivity coefficient must be taken, and it must be insulated so that we can save the heat that is getting leaked out of the furnace into the atmosphere. Now this equation can be written like this also. Q is equal to A into T1 minus T2 divided by X by K. Like this also we can write it. Now if the wall is composite, that is we have wall made of two or more materials, there are two materials used here and the heat is passing here, the temperature here is T1, here it is T2. Now the quantity of heat that will pass, this is, let us say this is material 1, X1, this is 2, so this is X2. Now this will be, Q will be equal to A into T1 minus T2 divided by X1 by K1, that is thermal conductivity coefficient of material 1, plus X2 by K2. So many joules per second. If they ask for minute, you have to multiply it by 60. If they ask how much heat is transferred in 1 hour, you have to multiply it by 3600, like that. So this is, on this formula you can get a numerical there. Also they can ask a problem on heat transferred through a metallic tube. Suppose some hot material, like say steam, is passing through a pipe, hollow cylindrical pipe it is passing. Now, how much heat is going out? This will be in the atmosphere. So, how much heat is going out? In that case, what happens is, in that case, quantity of heat that will be passing will be 2 pi L. L means the length of the pipe. The length of the pipe into T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by K into log of R2 by R1. So R2 means this radius, bigger radius, this is R1, R2 by R1 to base E. Again, if you see in the books, this E will not be there, they will put here instead 2.3. Now, because we have log to base E directly with us, that is in button, we need not do that. We need not take 2.3 here directly. You divide these by this, R2 and R1 if they are known to you, you divide R2 by R1, then you get some value. Press this button directly in your calculator, you will get the value of this directly. So you need not convert it into a common logarithm. Now, what we do here is, sometimes to preserve the heat, to lessen the heat, we may use an insulating material like this. Now, its radius is R3. Its inner radius will be same as the outer radius. This is one material. This is one material. This is another material. This is one material. This is another material. In that case, so many, again, this is joules per second. Q will be equal to 2 pi L into T1 minus T2. That is, T1 is the temperature here, T2 is the temperature here. T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by K1. That is, if you take this as material 1, 1 by K1 into log of R2 by R1. To base E, plus if you take as this as material 2, 1 by K2 into log of R3 by R2. This becomes the inner radius. R2 becomes the inner radius here. R3 is the outer radius to base E. So many joules per second. Here, in the previous formula also, A is in square meters. T1, T2 are in degree Kelvin. This R1, R2, R3, they should all be in meters. In meters. Their x also should be in meters. In the other formula that I gave, x should also be in meters. So these are the formulae that you get. You may get a problem numerical on this. I will do that numerical. Then this is that completes this. Subject, थोड़ा खड़ा ना, ये लिया नहीं, अप्रैल में 2017, क्वेश्चन नंबर 18A, The furnace wall is made up of bricks, 200 mm thick. A furnace wall So this is the wall of a furnace. This is brick. Its thickness is 200 mm. This is 200 mm. The inner and outer surfaces of the wall have temperatures 800 degrees centigrade and this is inner, and 200 degree centigrade. Determine the heat loss if the outside temperature heat loss, full stop. If the outside temperature becomes 25 degree centigrade after the furnace wall is covered with insulator of 100 mm thick, determine the reduction in heat loss. Take K for brick, that is this one, for brick, how much? 4.5 watt per meter degree Kelvin. And K for insulator, that is for the next, this thing, this is K brick is 4.5 watt per meter degree Kelvin. K for insulator, insulator is 0.5 watt per meter degree Kelvin. This is the problem for 7 marks. Now, here T1 is 800 plus 273, that is 1073 degree Kelvin. T2 is 200 plus 273, that is 473 degree Kelvin. It doesn't make any difference. Thing A is not given. If it is not given, area is not given, you take it as 1 square meter. Let us take it as 1 square meter. Now, in the first case, when there is no insulator, only this wall is there, what is the quantity of heat that is passing through the this thing, passing through the wall to outside? So, it will be Q is equal to A into T1 minus T2 divided by X1 by K1. So, Q will be equal to so many joules per second. A is 1. If it is not given, you have to take it as 1. 1073 minus 473, that is 600, divided by X1, 0.2. 200 mm means 0.2 divided by 4.5. So many joules per second. How much it is? It will be calculator. Calculate. So here, this is 600 numerator into 0.5 divided by 0.2. This will be 13,500 joules per second. This is the quantity of heat leaking to the atmosphere per second. Or it will be, if you put it in kilojoules, 13.5 kilojoules per second. Right. Now, what we do to prevent this, we are putting one more here. We are putting insulator here. This is insulator. Insulator. This thickness is how much? This thickness is after the furnace wall is covered with an insulator of 100 mm thick, that means it is 0.1 meter. This is 0.1 meter, this is 0.2 meter. Now, what is the reduction? So, this is, you can call this as Q1 earlier, that is before we were putting. Now, Q2 will be equal to, Q2 will be equal to same A into T1 minus T2 divided by X1 by K1 plus X2 by K2 joules per second. Now what will happen? A is 1, into this is same 1073 minus 473, that is 600, divided by x1 is 0.2 divided by 4.5 plus x2, that is 0.1 divided by 0.5, k2 is 0.5. So 600 divided by, now it is 0.2 by 4.5, 0.2 divided by 4.5, that works out to 0.044444044 plus this works out to 0.1 divided by 0.5, 0.2 I think, yes, 0.2. So it will be 600 divided by 0.244, 600 divided by 0.244, that will be equal to 2455 joules per second, or it is 2.455. So the what he is asking, what is the determine the reduction in heat loss, heat loss Q will be equal to Q1, what was going out earlier, and Q2 minus Q2, that is what is going out now, that is 13,500 was the, what was going, minus now it is 2455 joules per second. So the reduction is 13,500 minus 2455, that is we have prevented by putting that, we have prevented 11,045 joules of heat per second from going out. This is the advantage. This works out to roughly 11 kilojoules. Earlier it was 13.5 kilojoules. Now it will be 11 point something kilojoules. So that problem carries 7 marks. 7 marks. In the same question, 18B, we have another one more problem. Now this problem is like this. 18B. A metal pipe of external diameter 150 mm. A metal pipe of external diameter, that is D1 is 150 mm, external diameter 150 mm, carries steam at 200 degree centigrade. So T1 is 200 degree centigrade. The pipe is covered by a layer 25 centimeter thickness insulator thickness is 25 mm. Next, thick insulating material whose conductivity is point K insulator is 0.21 watt per meter degree Kelvin. If the outer surface is at 100 degree centigrade, that is T2 is 100 degree centigrade, 100 degree centigrade, calculate the amount of heat loss per meter length per minute. Calculate the heat loss per meter length. So L is 1 meter, time is 1 minute. So here they have not given sufficient information. Anyway, we will do it. Here there is a pipe in which steam is, this is steam, its temperature is 200 degrees centigrade. Alright, he hasn't given the radius or diameter, inner diameter is not given. He has given the outer diameter as 150 mm. A steam external diameter 150 mm carries 200. He has not given the internal diameter. Then this is insulated. Insulated, this is insulation. That means a material is covered on that. It is usually in steam pipes. It is called lagging. We use asbestos ropes around the pipes. Right. This thickness of this, he says, is 25 mm. He has given the value of K. This is 2. This is material 1. Let us assume D2 as 100 mm. So R2 will be 50 mm. This will be R1 will be 75 mm. Now this is 0.05 meter. This will be 0.075 meter external dia. For this, R2 will be same. R3 will be R2 plus 25 mm. That will be as, no, this is R1. This is D1, this is D2, this is R2, R3 will be R2. So this will be 100 mm, 75 mm plus this 100 mm, so that will be 0.1 meter, R3 will be 0.1 meter, so this, I have assumed all that. He has also not given, this is K2, this is, K2 is given as 0.21, K1 is not given in the problem. So you have to assume it as, say, some 2 watt per meter degree Kelvin. You have to write there, I have assumed. You can assume anything, usually 2 or 3, like that you can assume. Now Q is equal to here. 2 pi L into T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by K1 into log of R2 by R1 to base E plus 1 by K2 into log of R3 by R2 to base E. This is R1. This is R2, and this is R3. So there you have to make a substitution. Q will be equal to 2 pi into L is 1 meter. It is per meter, he says. So that will be 1. This will be, here it is 200, here it is 100. So 200 minus 100. Even if you don't add 273, the difference will be 100. If you add 273 also, the difference will be 100. Divided by 1 by K1, that is 1 by 2, into log of R2. How much is R2? R2 is 0.0075, I think, divided by 0.05 to base E plus 1 by K2. K2 will be 0.21 into log of R3 will be 0.1 divided by 0.075. R2 is 0.075. So this is what you get. Now take calculator. First do this slowly. 0.075 divided by 0.05. This will be equal to 1.5. 1.5 into half into 0.5. That will be 0.75. This works out to 0.75. Once again we'll do R2 0.075. I think I made a mistake. Divided by 0.05 equals 1.5. We want to take log 2 base e of this. In button, answer equals 0.4 something into 0.5, that is 0.203. This is 0.203 plus 0.1 divided by 0.075 equals 1 point something in divided by 0.21 equals, this is 6.35. This did I do it correctly? 0.1 divided by 0.075 equals this much. I think I didn't do it properly. In log 2 base e of answer, 0.287 divided by 0.21 equals, it will be 1.37. This will be 1.37. 1.37. And this is 2 into pi into 100. So 2 into pi into 100 divided by, this works out to 1.37 plus 0.203. That will be 1.573. So 2 into pi into 100 divided by 1.573. This works out to 399 point something, say 400 joules per second. He wants it per minute. So 400 into 60, that is 6 4s are 24,000 joules per minute, or it is 24 kilojoules per minute. That problem is slightly wrong, means data is insufficient. We have assumed some data. So these are the problems. You have to work out some more problems and see to it. Kidnava.